What's up, cuz?
Yo, what's up?
How you doing, bro? You already know what time it is, you know.
Guys, what to do? We are bringing you guys the first podcast with Exodius and Zero.
Number one, baby.
What topic are we going to be discussing today?
Well, here's what I'm saying, bro. I think we should talk about something that's really prominent in today's society. And I think one of the biggest things that's affecting everybody, no matter what age, what color, whatever it may be, you know what I'm saying? I think it's hate, bro. And I really think that we need to figure out a way to maybe flip hate and change it to be optimistic, if that's possible. Just because I don't really...
But see, the problem I'm seeing with people today is we support negativity. We're not really about that positivity. Like, the rappers, the music artists, we support negativity. The Catch Me Outside girl, negative. Like, we're supporting all this stupid negative stuff instead of supporting these positive people out here trying to do stuff.
I feel like that's 100% true, and I agree with that. A lot of people are putting out negativity, but I feel like it's not everybody. Like, at the same time, the general population, not the rich people who are in that position, you know, to put those videos out, to be able to put those stupid people in a position of power, you know, I think it's the fact that literally, we just literally have to... I'm trying to figure out how to put this into words. Like, we literally have to figure out how to not put those people...
But see, we support... Like, you see how many fight accounts we have on Twitter, like, posting fights and things like that? Like, we support fights more than we support someone doing something good.
We definitely will watch a fight, bro. I'll definitely watch a girl beat on another girl,
But that's completely against... Like, that's against what we're discussing.
Look, I understand, but I'm not going to be...
For every Chance the Rapper, bro, we've got, like, 521 Savages.
I feel like that's definitely true. It's more prevalent, but also it's about what people want to see, because those people are only relevant because of their fan base. Most of their fan base, you got looking deeper, is little kids, right? And where do those little kids
exactly
learn the violence?
But when we show these little kids all this negativity and violence, they grow up thinking that stuff's cool to do.
Well,
like,
at the same time,
you sold drugs, so that's what to do. That's what you gotta do to get to this place. And then they see these people blowing up and getting famous and getting money, and then they feel as if they have to follow that path. They
don't
create their
own. And at the same time, they're not taught in schools about the real, you know, what those paths can lead to. Because, yeah, anybody can sell drugs and whatever.
But school doesn't teach us a lot of anything, like, any life skills.
Life skills,
they,
yeah.
I feel like they take subjects and then continuously make them harder and harder to challenge you and to push you through 12, 13 years of it, and then another 4 dealing with college and everything, but they don't really teach you these life skills. They don't teach you how to manage your taxes. They don't
exactly
teach you any of that.
That's what I was about to say. They don't teach
you. Why do we have to have 4 years of government or 4 years of math or 4 years of English if that's not a subject field that we want to go into?
I feel like it's basically all a distraction, bro, because they could definitely condense all the courses you learn into one course that you could learn in probably the midst of, like, half the year. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's more information that they should be giving to you guys that they're not.
Well, I feel like they're trying to prepare us so if we... Because they feel as if we can't choose what we want to do under the age of 18. But I feel like everything is so based on a certificate. Like, there may be someone who's better qualified and can do the job better, but they don't have the certificate, so they're going to get the lower job. And this person with a certificate that's lazy and a bum that cheated their way through college or something is going to
get that big job with the big money.
Even though they're
not
going to be the one. Like, my English teacher used to say, there's the big A and then the little A. There's that big A, that the person that tried to get the A. Like, even the big B is better than the little A. The little A is that person that just...
That procrastinates
that person that
by,
just got by and still got that A. But then there's that person that tried, that's working to get that B.
Exactly.
And I feel like that's more, like, prominent to choose that person that's working hard, even if they're not doing as well, because they're going to accelerate faster because they're working towards it.
And I even feel like, to take it back a step, when you're in school, I think if schools want to get more of those big A's and they want to learn how to get children more into school, it's all about motivation and the way they
teach. Yeah, and it's about, like,
the more you motivate a person, like, look.
And trying to relate to them, too.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was about to say. In high school, look, if they would have had, like, real music classes teaching me how to produce or, like, how to do videography stuff. Yeah, they have tech stuff, you know what I'm saying? They have how to work the computer and how to work video camera. But, like, if they had gone in-depth and given me my choice of what I wanted to learn in high school, which is basically the college curriculum, is to set up basically, like, different classes on what you are going to do in the future, you know what I'm saying? If they set up like that, more students would be motivated to actually learn about stuff.
See, they try to base it on, like, this job is going to be available, and they try to make it like, oh, you can't be an artist because that's not, like, a real job.
Or you can't
make movies or something because that's not a real job. But really, anything is kind of based on that. It's based on demand. You can't run a business. Look at Walmart. Walmart wouldn't be making money if people didn't have a demand for them.
Exactly.
But these people, basic companies, like tire companies, car companies, these food places, none of them would be in the position that they're at if there wasn't a demand for that.
I feel that. It definitely, even to take it a step further than that again, like, as a demand, bro, anything you think of, like, anything, any word that comes out of your mind, any image, whatever, can become a demand. And that's what I really don't like about how they set the system up to believe, for you to believe the facts that you can't do necessarily what you want to do and still be successful and happy. You know, it's either
it's kind of their way or the highway, pretty much. It's kind of like, and I feel like a lot of parents are on that type of thing too, where it's either you follow what I'm going to put for you or I'm not going to support you in what you're going to do.
Exactly. It creates a disconnection
That's how we lose all of our creative minds.
Exactly.
And we have these morons out here spreading all this negativity, all this hate and all this stuff. And I feel like even me saying that could be considered hating on them. But no matter what you rap about, if you're giving back to your community or you're giving back to the people who got you in that position, I feel like I can still respect that.
All right, so wait, let me hear you say that again. You said literally if the person, no matter what they rap about.
As long as they're giving back to their community, they're taking care of their responsibilities. All right. Now, if you're out here, if you're rapping and you're still out there selling drugs, you're still, like, I understand. Right. People are pushed to that point where they feel as if they have to sell drugs.
Well, let me say one thing, bro, because certain people are actually in a position, like, if they don't sell drugs, like, they're going to die. Like, they won't have a place to live. They can't get jobs, you know, because of their felony records or whatever. That's most of Atlanta, but that's half of Atlanta, bro.
I feel that, but there's a certain point, like, I can see a difference between someone out there selling weed and someone selling crack cocaine or something that's truly gonna mess someone up.
Right.
And then if they make those impurifications in that drug that can possibly kill people and they realize that they're selling, that's messed up. But weed, it's illegal, but it's not harmful. Alcohol is more harmful. All this other stuff we have is more harmful than weed.
Yeah, I feel that. Honestly, my stance on it is literally nobody puts any type of drug in their system, bro. Nobody. You don't have a single, even ignorant people, they don't, like, crackheads don't put crack into their system like, oh yeah, this is gonna help me, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like an end of the road type of scenario. So my point is on it, like, let's forget about, like, we focus so much as, like, even in politics on drugs, man. Like, honestly, if we took a step back and focused on more important things, like, there are so many more important things we need to put into our community than worrying about small
things. And we put a lot of these negatives out there, like with shooters and stuff. I feel like the only reason these shooters, because you can see when one shooting happens, multiple shootings pop up.
Exactly.
And it's because they want attention. So when you put a shooter on the news, you're putting this negativity out there. There's many of those copycats trying to follow his lead, trying to get popular too, because they want attention.
Exactly.
They're these people that never got attention when they were younger, so they're doing something negative because negativity is what sells and gets them popular.
Exactly.
Like, half these people rapping about guns, drugs, all that stuff probably have never lived a life similar to that, but they see that's what's going to sell and make them records, and they feel that's what they got to do.
And they take advantage of that. Yeah. And so that's what literally is messed, I think is most messed up, is the fact that we don't have differentiation of music now. It's all, you got to either be hard or it's that other type of music that's mm-hmm. off to the side now, you know what I'm saying? I think that's corny, man. Like, I don't see why everybody feels the need to want to be so hard. Mm-hmm. It's like, for what?
Well, there's like...
For what, man?
There's different types of hard.
Well, you know what I'm saying? Well, like,
there's the hard, there's the shooting and the violent, the gang
there's
stuff.
A savage,
that's hard.
But, and then there's a, like,
but
going
you notice,
hard.
Like, the people, you can really tell the people who have been in that stuff because they're not the ones bragging about it. Like,
exactly.
The real gang members that we hear about, they're not the ones out there bragging about
like,
that
even
shooting.
Snoop Dogg,
stuff.
For instance. You
exactly. Like, he switched up his life.
Exactly.
So.
And he made it for the better. And look where he's at. He's got his own. He's his own news show. He's got his own television show.
But he's just got that personality. Like, the people back then from, like, the older eras, there were a lot more people with personalities. Like, you had to have a personality to kind of...
I think there's way more personality in the space today.
Really?
Honestly. And honestly, look, if you walked into the middle of California right now, of Calabasas, bro, you would see so many more, like, not even races, bro, just different types of people. Like, it's not just... Because back then,
I feel like it was rap scene, God scene. Well,
like,
maybe they're all more, like, mashing together now and getting along, but, like, I was seeing interviews, and they were, like, back in the day, they would make fun of the people for some of the stuff that they're rapping about and some of the stuff that they're doing.
Oh,
like,
yeah, this type
being
of rap
in, like,
definitely would have gotten away.
Being in
then.
The rap era and trying to be, like, a rock star and claiming you're a rock star and things like that, I feel like, there's a certain level of, like the rock star life, like the money, sex, the drugs,
right.
and all that stuff. But then these people are trying to dress like rock stars and do all that stuff. Like, they're not the same. They rap, but they're similar in many topics, and they weren't supposed to last. But you can't just mesh them like...
I feel like that's the whole point of what those people are trying to do. Because honestly, we're gonna break this down for the podcast right now. He hates Lil Yachty, Uzi, The Wave, all that.
I have no respect.
No respect for him. But me, you see, I respect the fact that they're able to do what they do and make mass amounts of money.
But I don't respect what they're doing.
I
respect some of
it,
but I don't respect the music. Because I guess Yachty and Uzi aren't, like, the negative, but I don't respect the Kodak, I'm glad you're making money and stuff, but I don't respect you putting that violence and stuff. You realize... Children are listening to you.
Right.
Like, whether it's right or wrong, parents can't stop all that. Parents couldn't stop us from doing it back when we were younger.
It's true, bro. We're gonna boys will be boys,
and
girls
will
be girls.
They know that kids are going to be listening to this music. Rap is what kids listen to. They don't listen
there,
to country. They don't listen
no
to
other type of music anymore.
Exactly.
It suits
the young
rap.
People.
Rap is the new.
It allows them to feel like they're not obscene. Like, they're not outsiders. Like, they fit in somewhere, but. When you realize that you have to take, when you make music, when you do anything, you have to take into account what age group is mostly going to be watching you. And if you realize these younger kids are going to be listening to you or watching you or something, and you still choose to promote this gang life, this life that is going to lead them to nothing but prison and they put out a false image to them. They make it seem like drugs and stuff is the only way to get there. Like, drugs and stuff is... the best way to get there.
It's true.
They don't put out the other aspects of it.
The bad part about it is it's self-advocation of drug use, but it's not intended. You know what I mean? Like, that...
Well, there's
for
like,
some of them, it's definitely intended. They're like, I don't give a fuck. Like, this is what I do. This is my life.
Yeah, and then
like,
there's two ways to portray it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Mac Miller, for example, he wasn't just putting it out there like he's doing that. He's like...
He changed
still,
music,
yeah.
you know,
He's
through.
Explaining that he shouldn't be doing this. And he's not, like, putting it out there like, oh, you should do this.
Well, I don't know, bro, because he definitely has advocated a lot of drug use. I'm not going to lie,
but
bro.
He's...
It's just the way that... I know what you're trying to say, though, because it's like there's a certain way you can put it out to where it's not, like, do drugs and...
Like, this
money.
Is what I had to do to get here.
Exactly.
This isn't the path
no,
that
no,
I
it's
want
more
you to follow.
Of a, it's more of a, this is how... This is what I did to get
here.
Yeah,
that's what I'm
saying.
Like, and then there's people who are just, like... They aren't including any of that. They're not including any of the struggle that they had and the reasons why they had to do that. They're just saying, this
just
is
saying,
what I did.
This is what I'm doing right
now. If they explain, like, this, so-and-so led to this, so-and-so meant I had to do this, I had to do this to support my family, yada, yada, then maybe there's a little bit more room. But exactly. When you're just explaining as, like, the way you do, these kids aren't, like, taking it as that. They're not taking it in like we're taking it in. They're taking it in as, he sold drugs, so let me sell drugs. That's the way I can become a rapper. He right. shot people, let me shoot people, let me join gangs. And once you join a gang or you do that stuff lives with you forever.
For the rest
you
of your
don't
life.
Ever get rid of that. Yeah, once you go to jail, that's on your record.
People don't understand. It's literally called the trap. People hear the word trap and they don't think literal trap. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, literally, you're like, trap. I'm stuck in a trap. Can't mm-hmm. get out. About to die in a trap. Mm-hmm. People think now, like, since that word has been so changed throughout the decades and literally morphed into this new type of word, people mm-hmm. will see that word now as actually, like, you know, either a type of music that's mm-hmm. bumping or something that's positive. But literally, in the name, it's what it is. It's a trap, bro. There's one way in and no way out.
I feel like we people portray positivity as corny.
I feel like positivity is just, it's pushed to the side because there's a lot of positive people that.
But I feel like okay, Chance, for example, like, we don't consider him corny, but like, say Lil Dicky, or just like
mm-hmm.
bringing rap into like the front field again.
It's more looked down upon, bro.
Yeah, I feel like, oh, you're positive, you're corny, or wow, you don't. We just look at it as like
wow,
something.
You haven't been through
yeah,
that
like generic
much,
or something. Like, there's people that choose to dwell on this anger, this life that they've been raised in, and there's people that choose to move on from that and try to appreciate the good
the
things
better
in their
things
life.
In life. Yeah. Exactly, and then there's even if you take it a step further, I think the best way to live life is a balanced life. It's to realize what could be and to also look mm-hmm. forward to to realize what could be and to also realize what could have been.
Well,
you know what
let
I'm
me
saying?
Ask you this. Cole said in his song, there's beauty in the struggle.
Alright, there's
on
beauty.
That? Like,
I think
you hear people talking about once they reach the top, like, it's over, but like, They miss that struggle. They miss that drive to let them succeed. That struggle that they had. They love the risk and everything. How do you feel about that?
I feel like the best way to describe that would be there is the beauty part in struggle is that it morphs you. Just like water literally erodes sedimentary rock, you know what I'm saying, and turns it into what it, like, the different layers and the different smoothness and textures.
Mm-hmm.
Those struggles you go through literally make you, like, the struggles J. Mm-hmm. Cole went through, the reason he's J. Cole is because he went through those struggles, mm-hmm. and because he got to realize what experiences could really do for him, you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? It's kind of like, I see it as, like, levels, like, XP is needed to get to the next level mm-hmm. in any video game, any
but
type of...
What do you feel, how do you feel, like, if you finally get to that point and you realize it's not what you want?
Well, like, then there's two paths, and you can see it in any artist. There's two paths you can take.
Some feel that they've gotten too deep to return from that. Like, you've gotten so, like, we see a lot of famous people committing suicide.
Yeah,
like,
and going crazy,
like,
is the biggest
thing. Obviously, money, fame, cars, all this stuff isn't truly
the route to happiness.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, it's a dope plus, but there's obviously something missed. Like,
It's
Kurt
the
Cobain.
Difference between
he had the money,
spending
he had all
the
of
money
that.
And letting the money spend you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel like there's people that just make the money to kind of flaunt it, but don't really make it to do it for themselves.
Anything,
a lot of people
right.
do things to show it off to others so they'll think they're cool or something, but they don't do it for themselves. They don't do it for the right reasons.
Right. Let me ask you this, because in one of Tyler's songs, he said, or no, in one of his interviews, I'm pretty sure he said that, what did he say? He said money. Shoot, I'm trying to remember. He literally said money doesn't.
Money ain't the motive.
Yeah. Dang, bro. How you about to ruin? Dang, bro. Anyways, had to cut that out. You know what I'm saying? But Tyler said money ain't the motive. He said that literally he met with many of people's favorite actors, actresses, all that. And what he saw was that money, you know, no matter how much you make, there's either two things you can do with it. He said, you can either let the money take control of you, or you can take control of the money. What's your stance on that? Do you feel like we have a surplus of people doing that right now, or do you feel like we need more of that? Like, more people taking control of themselves and the money instead of letting it...
There's only a certain amount of money I believe you need. Like, you get above the 100 million, 200 million, what do you truly need that money for? If you're not donating, if you're not... But even on the donating factor, we donate so much to foundations and stuff. And what kind of progress... How do we know this money is actually going towards finding a cure, finding, like, the truth? Because we've donated, let's just rough estimate, trillions to cancer foundations and stuff.
Trillions.
And where are these cures
really
at?
Gone?
It's been like that for like 10 years or so. Where are these cures at? You can't tell me all these bright minds. We hear advancements in the news all the time about kids making cures to cancer, all this stuff. Where are these cures going for? What happened to them?
Personally, I think these cures are literally being hidden from public's eyes so that people can monetize it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Just like the one guy that monetized the AIDS cure.
Mm-hmm.
That cure, as it was released, that cure had been out for, 5-10 years?
And then he
plus.
Bought it up the price.
Right.
That's an awful thing, because usually the people that are suffering from cancer, all these things, they're the poorer people.
Exactly.
They're the ones who can't do that.
Who can't help themselves with
and
any
with
type
health
of money.
Insurance, no matter what they're doing, they can't buy these things. They can't save themselves. So by doing that, we're basically saying that the poor lives don't matter. The richer lives are the only ones that matter, because they're the only ones that can afford the cures, the things to help themselves.
And that's where I really, really think this gap comes along between the regular class and the rich. I think the way that our government is set up, I think, honestly, down to the way they make buildings and supermarkets in your district is set up by where the rich people are going to be buying those things and, you know, where the poor people are going to be located. Because if you notice, you know what I'm saying, we could cut it in probably, 5-10 minutes.
Gotcha.
Is that cool?
22 minutes so far.
Dang, bro. Killing shit. But I really think that... you know, they place lower income people in the same area as the other lower income people, you know, for a reason. Just like there's, you know the gated, or you know the sections in your community where all the rich Jewish people live. Mm-hmm. Like, I used to live in Solon.
But I don't think we can stereotype Jewish people in that.
Well, I'm not, I'm saying, but in my town, at least in Solon, Ohio, like, there is literally an area.
Well, there were some Indians and stuff, like.
You know what I'm saying? No, I mean, there's a specific area where, like, the rich... I'm not, like, I'm obviously not racist. I'm
do you
just
think
saying,
they
like,
moved there based, like, they saw these... Do you think when they sell homes and stuff, they, like, they list the nationalities that are near them? Like, there's this many
there's,
Jewish people. There's this many black
people
here.
Get hit, bro. Best believe there's sites where there's all types of comments and ratings.
But do you think
the
they get
around.
Into, like, the Jew... Like, obviously... A lot of times they have, like, the blacks and the whites, because, like, the rich whites don't want to live near the poor blacks or something.
Right.
Like, or the ones that they feel may, like,
cause
there's people that are just scared of us
ignorant.
That, like, we're not the ignorant ones. There's people that are just scared of that.
Right. Honestly, it's reversed. Like, what you were just saying, like, the people that are scared of us are the ignorant ones, but they think we're ignorant, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They really don't. But with your question, I think it's a bunch of things that could be solved potentially. I mean, the first thing being, we really need to have a sit down and talk about race issues as a forefront, because as much as people want to dodge it, you know,
there's still race issues today.
With any problem you want to dodge, the problem's just going to get bigger. If you face that
problem,
the
more you run away from a problem, the bigger it grows behind you.
Exactly.
And the more you avoid it, the more people realize how weak an individual you are.
Exactly. And
like,
then
we'll go out into the world and there's going to be people that hate us, like, based on what they've seen from others. And I feel like that's kind of where the negativity and stuff comes from, because they see black people promoting a lot of this negativity and they fit that image on all of us.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they can never speak to us,
they
never talk to us, and they
could
just,
all in a box,
yeah, and they could just
I mean?
Think that we're ignorant or something based on our skin color, or we're ignorant because of what we listen to or something like
and
that.
And I mean, not everybody is like that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, obviously not, but there's select ones that wouldn't even give us a chance because
they
of our skin color.
They wouldn't give it a second thought. Because I've gotten those looks even recently when we were in that, I didn't even say anything, but when we were in that pizza, not pizza, that sub shop, bro. Like, I saw just the way people looked at me just, I mean, granted, I was acting ignorant, but at the same time, it's not like they know me. Like, they don't know my backstory. Yeah. You know,
and, then they try to judge, like, besides skin color, like, hair, clothes, the clothes you're wearing. Like,
right.
Personally, what I'm wearing, you're going to see me wearing sweatpants, all that stuff, probably until the day I die.
Exactly.
Whether I'm a millionaire, whether I'm piss poor, whether I'm middle class, exactly, or whether I'm a billionaire. Like,
that's just,
we judge too much on images. Like, we don't take, a lot of times we don't take the time to sit down with someone and judge their character and give them at least some type of fighting chance, and we just judge them on their, oh, he's fatter than I am, so, yo, he's a loser, or he wears glasses and he has this certain haircut, so he's nerdy, or he looks grungy and he smells bad. Like, there's things that you don't know, like, what people are really going through, like,
yeah,
until you walk in their shoes.
I feel like people should, or at least I tend to try to, you know, give people at least 5 minutes. Like, if you can seem like not an asshole in 5 minutes, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We cool, like, you my homie, but even, like, even assholes, like, there's still people, you don't know why that person is mad or upset or, like, been that way for a while. Like, you don't know their backstory, so it's always cool to give people that just, like, a good 5 minutes to get to know them before you even start to try to judge your character. And the biggest thing I wanted to bring up with you while we were in this podcast was, it's something big on race. The biggest question I have about race is, why do we call certain colors not what they are? And what I mean by that
is black people brown.
Yeah, look,
brown,
every
black,
single black person, I don't care how dark they are,
you're never pitch black.
Nigerians, I don't care if
you're
watching this, you ain't pitch black. There is no person on this earth that is pitch black, and there's no person on this earth that fits the pigment.
I feel like
white.
that was created as like an insult to us, like, you're darker than I am, so you're black,
right?
And then,
and negative emotions are associated, you know, more with darker colors like black, you know. So that might have been a factor, but.
Last question. How do you feel about us calling out immigrants and blocking immigrants and dealing stuff with that, since we're on the race issue?
I feel
what do you
like,
feel about, like, blocking certain countries from coming in but not others? And
it's genocide, bro. Look, all right, how did the Holocaust start, bro? First, they started to deport the Jews, you know what I'm saying? And then it escalated. This is the same thing. Like, literally every single move Trump has made, and I'm not saying Trump is Hitler. I'm saying every single move he's made has resembled moves Hitler's made. You know what I'm saying? Has resembled moves Stalin's made. Like, just people of overall, like, you wouldn't, you know, not the best people in history. Like, honestly, I feel like if we don't, like I said, we need to have this upfront conversation about it. If we don't have this conversation, even, like, to get people to talk about unity, we have to start the conversation,
see,
you know what I'm saying?
This is,
like,
how I feel.
Yeah.
Okay. The Jews were taking, no one spoke out for them.
Right.
Then they just went down race by race, and kept deporting
exactly
them and killing them.
That's the
and
same
no one
thing
spoke out for one another. And I feel like the problem is today, we feel too much, too entitled to our own selves. Like, we feel too so secluded that, yo, if it's not affecting me, then
yeah,
I'm
it's
not,
not
going,
in my
it doesn't
immediate circle,
me
then fuck.
Yeah, and I feel like that's why we're becoming so divided, because whether you support Trump or not, whether you support Hillary or not, they're still our president, and if they fail, then we fail as,
exactly,
as a country. If he gets attacked, we get attacked. Like,
yep.
And that's that. If we don't unite and speak out for one another, like, whether we have dividing opinions, I'm still going to let you speak, and I'm still going to try to take that into consideration, try to form a mutual opinion.
Exactly.
And everyone just feels like they're so entitled to their opinion. I feel like the internet kind of gives ground for that. They feel with the internet that, yo, my opinion's more entitled than yours, or I'm entitled to my own opinion, I don't have to listen to yours.
Exactly, yeah. It's narcissism, bro. Extreme narcissism that people have literally grabbed onto and latched onto and then just held onto it the whole time because of the internet, and because, like, there's people, literally people you would see sitting in their room all day just, like, quiet as fuck, not talking to anybody. Well, now they're on Twitter, you know, loud as fuck, 5 million followers.
Yeah, you could just the internet really gives people a false self entitlement.
It gives them a false voice.
And I feel like everyone's allowed to voice their opinions, but we shouldn't feel as if someone's wrong because they completely disagree with us. I feel like there's good and bad in everyone's opinion, and if we kind of formulated an opinion together, like we kind of
combined them all together opinion.
And kind of like tried to
create the best option out of all the
opinions, rational about it, then
you know?
We would be a lot more successful as a community.
And not even that, if we took that a step further, bro, and did that as a human race, we would literally, like, if we would have been doing this, the idea you just brought up, like, years back, we would have been on different planets.
We wouldn't have
by
all
now.
These wars and
we,
stuff.
Like, war wouldn't even be in our minds. We would be thinking about how to make
We all live on Earth. And as it shows, as NASA just announced, there's
five
there's some number of inhabitable planets, mm-hmm. which means that there may be a greater evil out there than ourselves.
Exactly.
And honestly, all we're doing is destroying ourselves as human beings.
And we've been doing this repetitively. History's mm-hmm. been repeating itself for
over and over again. No one wants
years.
To learn from it and see exactly. the signs.
That's why I think, honestly, the life form, if there are, I mean, there are more life forms out there, clearly, because look at how many planets have to be out there. But anyways, literally, if you look at that, it's like they're literally laughing at us right now. Like, mm-hmm.
They probably don't even want to come down and talk to us because they realize how ignorant we are and how we treat one another.
Exactly. Like I said, we could have been on different planets yeah. right now if everybody would have came as one.
Like we got the same blood flowing through our veins. We have the same basic structure. You're not going to look inside of me from someone who's white, Jewish, whatever you want
right,
to call
we're all
it, Indian.
Adams,
yeah,
you know
we
saying?
All have the same blood flowing through our veins. We all have the same structure and all that. Just because you're a different skin color doesn't make you any different than I am. I'm not going to judge
just
a white
light
car.
Skin and I'm actually dark, you know
shut,
what I'm saying?
Shut up. I'm not going to judge a white car from a black car and think that the black car is faster just because it's black.
yeah.
Like, we're just generalizing. We're not even generalizing for, like, the better good. We're just assuming, like,
assuming
we treat Muslims and stuff like crap. We treat immigrants like crap when we were all immigrants at one point.
Exactly.
Like, the original people here were Native Americans.
Native
we don't
Americans.
Even know if they immigrated from somewhere. They traveled on the land bridge over
yeah,
here.
Yeah, but of course we had to take over, you know. And
exactly. We take over those weaker than us and conquer them. And give them no chance to succeed, and then make fun of them because they don't have that chance to
right,
succeed.
Right, and then we do the things that literally we talk about us not doing.
Yeah,
that makes
we're
sense.
Contradicting.
Like,
we're
exactly.
contradicting as a whole race, as a whole community. All right,
so as an ending question, what is the biggest thing or things, honestly, that you think we as a society can do to help improve this, like, alarming, you know, just alarming factor of where we're at right now, or this alarming growth of where we're at and where we're going to.
I feel we can choose to set aside our differences and come together, because if we push it to a point, we're all going to start fighting and there's going to be no coming back from that. Like, we either stop it now, stop the demon now that's inside of all of us, or
right.
we keep pushing further and further to a warfare that ends everyone. It's like, unite together, save everyone, or it's like, keep pushing and everyone dies.
Yeah. Exactly.
And there's like, that's just how I see it. If we keep pushing for it, it's gonna come sooner or later.
And I can definitely agree with that, because it's like, look at the status of our environmental.
Like, if we all work together, you realize how much further as a society we'd be?
That's what I was saying earlier. I'm saying we'd be on different planets right mm-hmm. now if we were more focused on how we could develop
but
the human species.
Instead, we're
one.
Focusing on these
you know
stupid topics that aren't advancing anything, that are just kind of...
They're feel-goods.
They're there to kind of distract them from what's really going on and things like that. But with that question being said, you gotta end it.
You
know it's a long
saying.
Podcast, a lot longer than I expected.
It's huge. So. Shout out to the viewers, you know. keep it real. I have honestly no clue what you're about to call this, but whatever you're about to call it, shout out to that. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Apple. Apple products sponsoring this video. You know what I'm saying? Give me that sponsorship. Right,
shout out Steve Jobs. But hope you guys all enjoyed the first podcast. Many more to come.
Of course.
Sure, leave that like rating below if you enjoyed it. And
it's right there. The like is right there. Click
that subscribe
hit
button
that.
Too, yo.
Hit that bit, boy.
And leave a comment below what you think on some of these topics, some of these issues, what you'd like to see us discuss next week. And I will see you guys later.
Peace out, homies. Woo.